This is Science 2034. 20 years ago, the Science Coalition was formed to strengthen federal support for basic scientific and engineering research. We tell the stories of what federally funded research has made possible and what will be reality 20 years from now. Our guest today, astrophysicist France Córdova, the former chief scientist of NASA and the director of the National Science Foundation.
The U.S. can certainly take the path of some other countries, which is taking discoveries that have been made elsewhere and then turning them into marketplace ideas and technologies. That is a way to keep pace, just barely, with the world and be in the world of commerce. But it's not the way to be competitive and at the leading edge. If you want to be sure that you're out front and you're a leader and not a follower, then you have to be part of the enterprise that's generating the initial discoveries from which the inventions are made. There's no return on investment without investment. And the NSF has always been there to fund ideas at the very beginning. And those great ideas then produce discoveries and are used by the people who make the discoveries, or in many cases by others. They're joined with other kinds of discoveries and unusual partnerships, and they lead to real transformations. I mean, you take the cell phone, for example, which has several different kinds of technologies embedded within it. No one of those technologies would have had near the impact unless they were all put together by a mind that thought not just about the natural world and the world of discovery, but also the world of the marketplace and how can I produce something useful and that will improve the quality of life. And so that mind and others like-minded came together in unusual partnerships to produce a new kind of technology that affects all of us and has certainly been transformative. The National Science Foundation is one of the few places that does invest in all science and engineering. That's across all disciplines, including the social and behavioral and economic sciences. Our national challenges are, in many ways, global challenges, whether they have to do with the environment, the assimilation of new technologies, responses to risk and to disasters. And we have a lot to benefit by utilizing the great research that's being done in understanding other cultures, their languages, their communications, their ways of interacting, and just understanding social change in individual response, but also organizational response. Only by combining with the humanities and the social sciences can we really meet the goal of addressing grand challenges. Every science and engineering domain I can think of will have amazing advances in the next 20 years. In my own field of astrophysics, the kinds of discoveries that have been made in the last two decades are just mind-blowing. Discoveries about the nature of the center of our galaxy, about the black hole at the center that we didn't know 20 years ago. Discoveries about planets orbiting other suns, and now we know that there are thousands of such objects, and we can look forward to the day when we can image, perhaps in the next 20 years, another Earth-like planet that is like our own blue marble orbiting the sun, but it'll be orbiting another sun and be able to do the spectral signature work that will indicate that there is life of some kind on that other planet. And then going out to the cosmos at large, we'll be able to understand more about the merges of galaxies and the birth of stars, and especially about the this mysterious new form of matter energy we call dark energy presently, which comprises almost 70% of the content of the universe. And we are building a number of new telescopes in order to investigate the nature of dark energy and also dark matter that comprises about 20%, 25% of the content of the universe. So we have all of that to look forward to in the next 20 years with the kinds of instruments that we're building right now. The science workforce has changed so much in the last two decades that it is really wonderful to think of what it's going to look like in the year 2034. I think it will comprise more diverse communities of people working together. I think we'll see scientists, behavioral scientists, natural scientists, we'll see artists, design people, all working together on common problems. We'll see people from different backgrounds, different disciplinary understandings coming together to invent things and to create new markets. We'll see young people that'll be respected for their new ways of looking at the world and also their perhaps better, deeper understanding of new technologies that they as they evolve, collaborating with the older, wise people that have had lots of experience in the world of policy making and all coming together and working together. So there'll be more diverse and more integrated teams of researchers. Young people inspire me very much with their passion and their enthusiasm, with their openness to new ideas, and with their just desire to go out and to make a difference, with their belief that every moment counts and that they want to put all they have into it. And my advice to them would be to hold on to those things because they're so important in making discoveries and making a difference.